Roll initiative.
Hello, new dungeon masters, and welcome to the DM Screensaver. These are instructional videos to all those of you who are new behind the DM screen. I will be taking from my near decade of experience of dungeon mastering to teach you all the tricks that I've learned over the years. I'm making these videos with two purposes in mind. The first is to teach you all the individual processes it takes to prepare for a Dungeons & Dragons game, from world building to session planning to combat encounters, all the little stuff. Second is all these videos and all the content in them are completely free and will be a 100% playable campaign titled The Legend of the Necromancer's Sword. In this first video, we're going to do one of the most important things, in my opinion, that a dungeon master can know how to do, and that is design an NPC. We're going to start by designing, in my humble opinion, the most important NPC, the Tavern Keeper. So, let's get to work. So what we've got here is a list of backstory attributes and personality descriptions I worked through when designing my various NPCs. I have a few more things that I like to add to the plot essential NPCs, and several of these things I'll leave out when I improv the filler ones. So let's just dive right in and build this Tavern Keeper. We're gonna skip the name for now, unless it just came to you out of nowhere, like an epiphany or a week old burrito. Otherwise, names are difficult to make fit the theme of the environment in which you're putting your players without it sounding dumb or corny. So we're gonna come back to it, because hopefully while we formulate this character as we design him, we'll get a nice name for him. Pro tip! You can't predict all your players' choices, but you can have a pre-generated list of names that you can assign to NPCs that you didn't think your players are going to go and talk to. There's a ton of online generators you can look up to compile a list of a couple pages of names that you can just assign to NPCs. The first three underneath name are pretty important, but they can be planned quickly. You got race, age, and class. For our Tavern Keeper, we're going to use an uncommon race that I really love keeping in store for special occasions. This is the Dragonborn race. Dragonborns are a humanoid dragon race that resemble their gigantic counterparts. If you're new to D&D, let's break this down for you. There are basically two kinds of dragons. You got the metallic and the chromatic dragons. Metallic are the more majestic and mystical dragons, while chromatic are the untamable forces of nature that seek power and just cause endless destruction. That said, we're going to make our Tavern Keeper a golden dragonborn. Why? Because it's going to look really cool when we get to the appearance. Age is next. I want to make this Tavern Keeper pretty old, very cantankerous and hardened by years of living in a dangerous world kind of vibe, so we're just going to write down really old right there. Perfect. Class is really simple to plan for NPCs if you don't have a secret backstory for the character. In the back of the monster manual, you have two indexes. One is for a bunch of animals, which is helpful if you have a druid and all them wild shapes. But after that one, there's a nice NPC index. This has stat blocks for all kinds of different non-player characters. This is a really great resource if your characters are prone to causing combat. That way you don't have to make up stats on the fly for this character. It's really useful if that is the way your team goes, or if your group is just a bunch of murder hobos. So in that index, we're going to assign this Tavern Keeper the common stat block. That's a really great thing to pull for this guy. It might not come up, but having those numbers pre-generated helps a lot if your team is chaotic or just prone to violence. Personality and quirks. Like we wrote down a second ago, we want this guy's personality to be argumentative and gruff because he's old, and because there are a lot of abilities in D&D that revolve around damage output and stealth, and a lot of players hone in on these because they're really flashy. But part of being in another world is being able to talk to the people who live there, much like the real world. How else are the players supposed to find adventure, reap rewards, build fame, if they don't communicate? And we also want our Tavern Keeper here to have the quirk of spitting at the end of his sentences. Yeah, not a huge thing, but some fun. Appearance. He's a Tavern Keeper, you know, we want to have that regular Tavern Keeper feel with his clothes. You know, the rolled up sleeves, the apron with, you know, drink and meat stains on it, the usual. We're also going to, in this appearance, make him old man strong, you know, so he's able to hold his own when he has to throw out degenerates and hoodlums. And here's where we're going to plan the surprise for our players to really draw their attention. We're going to plan for his entire left arm to be mechanical, just this machine of axles and gears and such. Now, I'm not going to plan where his arm went, like what happened to his arm, because I personally like to leave a little room for improv. Plus, we're making him difficult to talk to, so this will be a challenge for the players, and you're going to make it up on the spot. So, good luck with that one. While working on appearance, I often like to practice the voice for this character, if this is a character I plan for the group to talk to. I like to write down an opening line of dialogue, that way when you read it real fast, you know what they're going to say, and you remember the voice you have planned for it. You're not caught off guard stammering until you throw out just your average cliche adventurer sentence. So we're going to write down, water or whiskey, you'll be paying either way. That's what he's going to ask them when they first walk in. So to really start preparing a voice, we're going to go old lizard first. Lizard, you have elongated S's and T's. And old, you want to make it airy and just drawn out as if the words take a lot of effort to say.
Water or whiskey, you're paying either way.
This is pretty good. It makes him sound pretty old, but we're going to throw an accent in there as well, so.
Water, whiskey, you'll be paying either way.
With that voice prepared, you can now remember it when you see this sentence on your planning or the character's specific sheet, so you can just toss the accent out there. So next, we've got alignment. We're going to make this guy lawful neutral. It's pretty basic. Nothing too strange here. Yeah, we're going to move on. Organizations and faith is fun to plan for characters, but I'm not planning on this dude having a shady past or anything in that realm. And talking about faith with non-priest NPCs is really rare. So we're just going to write here the name of his tavern as his organization, which is the Golden Goblet. Rumors and quests. Here's how the tangled cobweb of my brain sorts this section out. Rumors are things inside the town or the specific building the players are in and can explore. So let's make a fun rumor that I find usually freaks out players. Let's say that there is a possible vampire in the town's nobility. Dun dun dun! And then quests are things that will be taking your players out into the countryside and exploring into the dungeons and adventure and conquest and mayhem and damage and possible death. We're going to say the local ruler has ordered a retrieval of a family heirloom from a group of rapscallions called the Rot-Tooth Bandits. Pro tip, take note of these banditos. We'll be coming back to them in a later episode. Dun dun dun. Alright, now that we know everything about this guy, it is time to decide who this robo-dragon is. I'm going to make his name having different elements. Some part of it's going to sound fantastical and the very novel-esque name. And the last name, or surname, we're going to give him a tribal-feeling name. We're going to name this guy Dronesall Rufftalon. Boom. Alright, there it is. And yes, I did decide on this name before filming because names are still pretty tough. Now, I don't always draw my NPCs, but I do like to do it on important ones. It helps me visualize them for when you describe them to your players. Anyway, I hope this video has been helpful. The next one will be coming soon, and I hope you are learning some of the tricks that I picked up in my experience, and this helps you become the best DM you can possibly be.